A few months back, I spoke on how people was complaining about how they were complaining about why money is being sent overseas when we need aid here. And in this case, they were talking about Israel. So I went to one of these comment boards. I think it was Democracy Now. And I asked a few people who I saw complaining. I asked, "Do you know why America sends all of this aid to these other countries?" And people got hostile with me, and one person came straight out and told me, "I don't care, just don't do it." And I'm thinking, you're complaining about resources being shipped out, but you're telling me that you don't even care why. Now, this clip I'm gonna play, it happened over a month ago on July 17th. It's a Foreign Relations Committee hearing. I saw it back then, but I'll use it to go along with what's going on with this Afghanistan thing these days. And so that people don't think I'm being petty and trying to just get a I gotcha moment, I'll try to put it in context afterwards.
We're asking for a 15% increase in the welfare that we give to other countries. And really, I think it's irresponsible. It's the wrong thing we should be doing. We should be conserving our resources, particularly conserving them for our country as opposed to sending them to other countries. There's not a great deal of evidence that the money that we, launder throughout the world really over time has been a benefit to us.
Did he just say the money we launder? Now, I know we all slip up and confuse words while we're talking. At first, I thought maybe he meant to say loan. Then I thought, but the only similarity in loan and launder is the L at the beginning. So to me, it sounded like he accidentally told on everybody. Let me play it again because I don't think that the word he used was by mistake.
We're asking for a 15% increase in the welfare that we give to other countries. And really, I think it's irresponsible. It's the wrong thing we should be doing. We should be conserving our resources, particularly conserving them for our country as opposed to sending them to other countries. There's not a great deal of evidence that the money that we, launder throughout the world really over time has been a benefit to us. There's a great deal of evidence that much of it's been stolen. We mentioned corruption. Well, yeah, there's plenty of corruption, and often the government-to-government money has been stolen through the years. But some of it's spent on things that are just, if the American people knew about them, would be outraged. Some of the aid money went to, spreading green growth in Peru, some sort of climate alarmism, selling Serbian cheese, venture capital fund in Bosnia, small business loans to people who've been deported, dealing with truant Filipino youths. In Afghanistan, we spent $60 million on a hotel that was never completed. It was a shell of a hotel across from our embassy.
Then he proceeds to talk about crime. And this is why I do think he meant to say loan, but the real slipped out of him. Because sometimes our subconscious will tell on us right in the middle of us trying to lie to somebody. Rand Paul started to talk about crime, started naming businesses like the hotel and the cheese place. In the business, and we all know that businesses are used to launder money. To me, it sounded like he was trying to say, hey, these countries we using to help us steal money from Americans are stealing the money from us that they're supposed to be helping us steal. No honor amongst thieves no honor amongst thieves is what it really sounded like to me he was mad at.
1,325,623. 200,000 more.
Get up and take a look.
Freeze! Get him up! Get your hands up!
Put your hands against the wall, turn around.
You're not kidding.
Put him up against the wall. You're under arrest for violation of the RICO statute. You have a right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be taken against
you. Hey, fuck you! How do I know you guys are cops, huh?
What's my say, asshole?
Oh, that's pretty good, man.
Now, presidents, I'll go as far back as Kennedy. All of them, either while they were running for office or when they was already in office, all of them are asked about bringing the troops home from somewhere. Vietnam, the U.S. touched down over there, I think it was in the 50s, but didn't leave until the 70s. About 20 years. So this idea about a slow withdrawal from Afghanistan is 2 decades late. Biden gets in office and pulls the trigger on these 2-decade-old withdrawal plans, and people are asking, well, why didn't he withdraw the troops slowly, or why didn't he have a better exit plan? Me, I don't think it could be such a thing as a better exit plan. Because every time troops withdraw from someplace, whatever they was there to stop, it starts to consume that place again. Militias, warlords take the place back. And that happens all the time. Now, whatever nefarious reasons Biden had for doing that, I suspect it'll be revealed sooner or later. And this dude had to know that the people over there were going to start getting slaughtered. He had to know that. And something I spoke on this a while back. I think I described it as some kind of ritual. But no matter how many times people see this, they pretend that they still don't see this. When somebody get in the White House, I'd say within the first 90 to 180 days, they kill somebody. Obama did it real quick. Trump, he dropped what they called it, the mother of all bombs on Afghanistan within 90 days of him being in office, and now Biden. And go back and search the other presidents, not just the ones I named, but before them, and you'll see that it appears to be some kind of initiation where you got to kill some people. Some people got to get sacrificed is what it looked like to me. Now, why the United States is in these foreign countries to provide aid? I'm almost sure that nobody who listens to this video believes that America is this benevolent nation that cares about the well-being of others. I hope nobody believes that. And I bring that up because what Biden just did, it looks contrived. But people are saying that he made some sporadic move that wasn't thought out. Me, I say that's bullshit. That's nonsense for a lot of reasons. Like when I look at all of the equipment that the Taliban acquired, helicopters and all kind of other military equipment, and they'll just leave it? Nah. They might as well call themselves something else now because they're essentially a new army. Taliban 2.0 or something. I saw that. What it looked like to me, I saw that Biden formed a military. That's what it looks like to me. I could be wrong, but that's what it looks like. The Taliban could be just that resistant to where the United States said, "The hell with it, we out of here." But that's not what it looks like to me. You know, people are saying that Biden did it sloppy, but me, I say he did it in a way that the person who didn't give a damn would do it. That's what it looked like to me. Didn't look sloppy, not sloppy. Because sloppy would mean that he made a mistake, but that didn't look like no mistake to me. It looks like something he should go to jail for, but you know, we all know better than that. We all know American presidents don't go to jail for war crimes. They'll just make sure that everybody else in these other countries end up in prison or at the end of a firing squad or something, you know. But again, maybe that was the compromise, leaving all that equipment behind and everything, leaving everything open to attack. So maybe because the Taliban did refuse to give up, it looks like a deal was made. But in whatever scenario, it looks like that a deal was made. But meddling in foreign affairs. You know, we like to complain about why America is in these places. Well, but, you know, if the United States is not there, then you'll have to hear about all kinds of atrocities, like the ones you're hearing about now. You see, you hear about what they're doing to the citizens over there already, but, and, you know, they're just getting started. And it has nothing to do with them being what we call a third world country full of primitive people either. Because the same thing would happen here if they defund the police. We're done. So you do need police. You even need world police. And you know what? It kind of even looks like a pre-planned reason to go back into Afghanistan at a later date.